Thank you to our sponsor for curating this collection. Let's score art based on 14 qualities. Use our 9-point scale to score how clear and smart each quality is used. Reply 1, 2, or 3 for low quality. Use 4, 5, or 6 for okay quality. And 7, 8, or 9 for high quality. So now, let's score this art. Hey, welcome back to Art Score. We're going to take a look at this Degas painting called A Young Woman with Ibis. So looking at the painting, I give it a 9 for subject. There's a clear subject. The woman is the subject. The woman on the terrace. See, originally this painting was just painted with her on the terrace. There was no city in the background. There were no ibises. And then that came later. So the story, I give it a 7. Now, anytime I give a 7 in this specific painting, I want you to understand, the reason why I give it a 7 is because the artistic factor that's being evaluated at this moment, in this case, story, it's done at a level where it's present, but it's not pushed or developed enough. Primarily in this specific painting, the reason why that occurs is because this painting was never really meant to be published or put out there. He created this painting in 1857, but then a few years later added the city in the background, and then later on added the ibises. And so it almost feels like he was constantly thinking through it and adding things and trying to figure out what the muse was trying to say. Ultimately, I'm not sure he actually finished it or hit it or completed it, because the ibises are not really completed. They're kind of just sketched in. The story isn't clear. So anything that I give a 7 in this specific image, understand that it's because ultimately he didn't bring it to fruition. He was going in that direction, leaning on his talents and his skills, but not polishing it, not refining it. And so story, I give it a 7. Same with medium. Degas is a master composer, designer, painter. In this specific painting, when you look at it, the quality of the materials, you can tell he has control over it. But again, he's not finishing it off. Same with color. There is a nice use of blue-green against all of these red-oranges. But again, the red-orange ibises came years after he did the girl. So ultimately, there is a color intelligence there. So I give it a 7. So it means it's a yes, but it's not a high yes at all. Values, the same thing. Values are working. You can see there's value intelligence there, but again, they're limited. They're not refined, they're not polished. Style, I give it a 6. It's actually quite low because it's a Degas painting. You should know that it's a Degas painting. And yet this painting, when I look at it, don't know it's a Degas painting. And doesn't look that different than maybe some of his idols. So my opinion, as he's going through this painting, producing this painting, he's leaning more on the people that he loves and respects versus leaning on his own voice and his own talent. Structure gets a 7. Movement. With the movement, that's very interesting. He has this beautiful curve coming down the woman's dress, around the back of her head, through her hand down, and that's really gorgeous. But then we have the movement in flowers. We have the movement in the ibis, and they really don't work. They start, but they never really pull together, and they seem disjointed. And so I give it a 7. Yes, you can tell he understands curves. He understands movement and arabesques, but it's not, again, polished. It's not brought to that higher level. Same with the edges. I give it a 7. When it comes to soul, I give it a 6 because it's the same problem. Now, what do I mean by soul? So there's an idea called a change of charge, where you have two different emotions in a painting. And as your eye acknowledges one emotion and then sees the next emotion, there's a transition in time. And so there's this movement that occurs. And the mind has to then figure out what's the meaning of it. So for example, with a woman's face is, and you look at the sky, it's very calm. But as you move down and you look at her dress where her hand is, there's a lot of lines that causes your eye to have to acknowledge that, read that, cross over it, pass through it. It's a lot of visual friction. And so the difference between that, you have to ask yourself, well, why? Is she pregnant? Is she contemplating pregnancy? Is there something that's going on in her womb belly area, that there's all that energy down there and her mind is contemplating these things? Or maybe she's desiring something, you know? And so but her mind is kind of in this suspended state while her body is very twisted and active. And so as you read the calm part and then your eye goes into that twisted active state, the mind then says, what is the meaning behind that? Why did the artist choose to transition us from one of consciousness to another? This is part of soul. And so I give it a 6. Pattern, again, I give it a 5. Because even though I see some things that are going on, like the two hands, the two ibises, the city in the back, and how the value and the color of the city in the back, and how it's the same value and color of the flowers in the front, I see those things, but again, they're not jiving together well, and so they don't seem like they were really thought through. Harmony, I give it a 7. For the most part, as my eye travels around the edge and then comes into the center of the image, it works well, except for where the eye goes up through those flowers, and right underneath that ibis, the one at the top, underneath it, my eye gets stuck in that little city behind there, in that city behind it. And then when my eye goes up over the ibis, it gets caught right behind the back of his neck. And then as my eye goes up the ibis's head, his beak throws me off the top of the canvas. And so all of these things need to be cared for and modified. And I'm sure Degas would have gone back and finished the painting. He would have modified all those things for them to work much better. But there's just too many things, like the space between her mouth and the ibis's head. Your eye gets caught in there a little bit. And so these are some of the issues that I'm feeling in terms of the harmony. Now, I give him a 7, but I can't give him an 8 or a 9 on that stuff because it's just not there. I looked over this painting. I could not find a signature, so therefore I'll give it a 0. And that is what it is. And most likely, he didn't sign it because he never finished it. And so this is a very cool painting that was found when he passed away, but it's a painting that was never finished. So I give him an 89 out of 117 points, which comes out to a 76%. Now, obviously, this doesn't reach my 85% threshold where you should be buying a painting. But if this came across and you could buy it, I would totally tell you to buy it. Not because the work itself is of a high quality, because it's not. It's of about 76%, but because it's a Degas. And so you have to bring in those aspects to evaluating the value of a work of art. And so you're not really buying the art for the art's quality. You're buying the art because it's attached to an artist's name, and the clout of that artist gives a greater value to this painting. But if we're just looking at the painting, minus all of the stuff that's outside of the painting, artist, the provenance, air, all those things, I mean, just look at the artwork itself. The artwork is cool, it's nice, but it really doesn't meet that threshold of something of a museum quality work of art. Special thanks to our Companions of Art and Culture. Thank you for sponsoring this video and helping us nourish many more souls with art. Subscribe to the channel, like this video, and click the notification bell so you don't miss out on our newest video. Try art scoring another painting by clicking the video on top. For details on becoming a sponsor, watch the bottom video. Always remember, you count to art. And on that, we all say, Umbrella.